This is Sam, the millionaire. Rico Suave here is going to be also going undercover trying to meet some women, but it's not really that undercover, if you know what I mean. She's going to go in to the heart of the evil men empire and show us what these men are trying to do.
Hi, I'm Natasha.
The mole.
I'm the mole.
Yes.
I'm going
undercover. And she's married, so take your ring, take it off. We got Tim, the token black guy at the conference, is going to try to meet a wife here, and we'll see what that happens.
We have a future MIT graduate right here that we're about to shop here at the conference to see if we can find a wife. So as we walk through the lobby here at the ABS conference, we're seeing a lot of interaction from different people. It's very exciting what's going on. Are you guys meeting here for the first time?
No, we're very long-time friends.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Just friends. We went up to the single session.
Oh, cool.
About that?
No, we wanted to go, but we're too late.
Are you guys on the market?
I'm on the market.
Really? How about you? Are you on the market?
I cannot disclose that.
I like that. On camera or just curious?
I cannot disclose that.
Yeah. And can I just ask you one more question?
Yeah.
What do you look for? What is the thing that you...
I think one key thing right now is openness to a relationship. I've noticed there might be some...
Like this guy. Like he's like, oh, I can't disclose that information.
Yes, there's some hesitancy I've noticed.
Yeah.
I don't know, this is just my own subjective encounters,
but
some men seem to be not quite ready for that part of their life yet.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So.
Okay, well that's excellent.
Have any guys hit on you here at this conference?
Be honest. Perhaps, but I probably wouldn't be able to tell the difference.
You wouldn't be able to tell the difference? Why not?
No, because I'm quite innocent.
Really?
Yeah, and I treat everyone as a friend and like...
Have you found any guys that you're interested in?
In what way?
He's kind of good looking. He's got something going for himself. I like him.
Oh, yeah, tons.
Tons. Yeah. Azad, how you doing, man?
Doing great, Benny. How about you?
Hey, how are you? I'm Benny.
Absolutely.
What's going on over here?
Not much.
Tell us about what you guys are talking about.
Oh, we're just catching up. This is an old friend. I haven't seen her in a few weeks.
Azad is a catch. Would you agree?
This is for real.
Come on, this is totally for real. We're doing a documentary, man.
A documentary.
Wait, where are you going? Come on. What just happened there?
She just ditched me. That's what.
Were you hitting on her or what? Was
she... No, she's a friend.
An old friend or a new friend?
Old friend.
Okay, let's be honest now that she's gone.
Interested in her?
She's an old friend from back home.
Just tell us if you're interested. Come on, do this documentary. Are you being politically correct?
I mean, I don't know.
Did you know there was speed dating going on upstairs?
Yeah, that was interesting.
Did you go?
No.
Oh.
I thought it was interesting. I wanted to go, but I didn't think it was fair of me to go and be amused by it.
All right.
Because they don't even call it speed dating. It's rapid, what is it, character investigation?
Exactly.
So, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, you just saw us... You just witnessed us get in between some speed investigating down here in the lobby, and we broke it up. The camera broke it up, but it was awesome. Okay, will you do us a favor? If you get a live one, can you just let us know?
So what questions would you ask him?
So,
what kind of
character
stuff do you want
to know?
Yeah,
character investigation.
Or better yet, what do guys ask you that you've met? I know you've met some guys here.
Okay, well, we won't go there, but...
really?
What have guys been asking you?
We have a lot of good questions.
She got uncomfortable, didn't she? You got a little uncomfortable with that, didn't she?
Alarm went off. Huh?
Guys been asking you some weird questions, huh?
No, but I had a really good question. Would you ever consider pioneering?
All right, so we're doing a little sum on the meat market here at ABS. Can you shed some insight on what's going on down in the lobby?
What's really going on?
I'm out of it. I don't know what's going on.
I know you're not out of it, but you're looking around. See what's happening here. What do you see?
A lot of new faces out here for me, you know. You know, we got the young girls out here too, which is really nice. I'm not that picky in particular. I'll take what I could get. No way.
I like that.
So are you single?
Yes.
Yes, you are single?
I'm single.
It seems a lot of the Persian guys here sort of hesitate when we ask them that question. What's that all about?
Fear of commitment, maybe. Keeping the options open. I don't know.
Are trying to cheat?
No. I'll never do anything like that.
That's what I want to hear. Now tell me, what do you look for? What do you look for in the ladies here?
Brains. I love brains. I love personality a lot.
No nice guys at the conference?
Oh.
Why?
No.
No.
So what do you do? What do you do?
We go to the session.
What do you look forward to when you come to these kind of conferences?
I look forward to learn more.
To learn more.
Somebody's not being truthful.
Did you
guys just meet?
That's a long story. I think we know each other. We're just trying to, I guess, remember where we know each other from.
Are you guys single? Both of you?
I am. Yeah.
Yes.
Do you feel like this is a kind of place where you can meet somebody that you can maybe have a not necessarily each other, but just in general?
For sure. I think so. You get to make some connections and kind of build on that, and it's, you know, but it's a good starting point, I think.
And what do you look for?
In
general.
I think the right attitude more than anything. Someone who has a good attitude about life. And
for example, does she have a great attitude?
For sure, absolutely. From what I've gained so far, yes.
Do you come here thinking that you might meet somebody?
No.
When you get dressed in the morning, are you thinking, I gotta look attractive? Let's be real, let's be honest.
No, I work, so I'm in my work clothes.
How about you?
Yeah, if I'm honest with myself, I have to say yeah.
I love it. Tell us a little bit about ABS and what's going on here with the meat market.
Well, it's interesting. You've got about 1,200 people, I heard, registered.
Let's be real. You would be considered a Baha'i catch.
Are you a Baha'i catch?
Yes or no?
You want to know?
People may say that.
Some people may say that. I certainly don't know what they're talking about.
Being very humble.
I will say that there are a lot of really cool people from different walks of life here. I think it's all about compatibility and sincerity and just being yourself.
Have any of them turned into real relationships?
I can say that, you know, at times I have met people at conferences that usually live pretty far away from you. Sometimes it might lead to a long distance relationship. Those may work, those may not. Depends on the person.
Didn't work for you is what you're saying.
I wouldn't go that far.
Right. Well, we'll keep tabs on you. We're going to be following you around.
Sounds good.
Tell us about ABS, specifically the ladies here.
The ladies are intimidating. And
you haven't seen any lookers here.
No, not yet, but
you're looking.
I'm looking.
We're still looking.
Both you guys are looking.
Not me, no.
You're looking for him.
Looking for him. I'm related to that beautiful girl right there.
That one back there.
The one back there.
Is she single?
She's single.
What's her name?
Bita.
Bita. Bita, we need to talk to you. Come on. Come on, Bita. Come on.
Come on, Bita.
We'll come to you if you don't come to us.
We're going to give you international exposure.
So what do you look for?
In women?
If you meet a woman, what do you look for?
She has to have, you know, a good smile. She has to be a good mother. I have to be able to tell that already, you know? She has to be good in service to others, selfless person.
And being that you have a daughter, how's that for you? I'm sure she's brought guys to meet you, and you're never good enough.
No, she's busy studying right now.
So no guys right now.
Let her finish her education first.
And you'd like to see her. You'd like to see a family.
She's too young. I think kids they should marry when they're a little bit more mature.
Oh, okay. Is there an age? Well, you got an age around that? What do you think?
Guys around 55.
Wow. The best thing about guys is we have plenty of time. The longer we wait, the more options we have.
Wow, look at that. Right. How are you? We just talked to your dad.
Oh, really?
He told us that you're studying right now and you're in school, so you shouldn't be worrying about guys. How do you feel about that?
No, he's right. It's not in my mind.
There's a lot of guys here, professionals, guys that are doing well in their careers. I'm sure those guys are trying to talk to you. How's that been going?
That's kind of non-existent.
So we're here at the conference, and this has nothing to do with the two of you talking. Obviously, people are here trying to meet each other, trying to get married. A lot of people meet somebody in a relationship. How do you feel about that? Do you see it, or do you not see that?
I see a little bit of it. Well, I just went to the session.
How was it?
It was excellent. There were some parts that could become better, but overall, it was a great opportunity to get to know oneself and to get to know a few other people.
No. Do you think you can meet somebody at a Baha'i conference that maybe you'd end up marrying?
I don't know whether I could. I certainly could meet somebody. I've met a ton of people at Baha'i conferences. Whether I could marry them, it's a whole different story.
Pedram, are you interested in her?
not in that way.
Not in that way?
We're friends.
Why not? Does she not have some qualities that you're looking for?
No, I wouldn't say that. I've never really thought about it.
She's a beautiful woman.
It's very true. It's very true.
As a parent, I'm sure you hear other parents talk about it.
I don't know. I don't think just coming to a conference, you know, would be enough to find your soulmate. Mm. But maybe it's a good beginning.
But you'd rather than meet a spouse at a conference than in a club.
Of course, sure.
So this might be the best place they can.
The Baha'i activities, when they do community services, that would be the better way to do it.